Hi folks, there is good news for all the travel hippies around here. This week we have chosen to make a video on how to write a travel blog. The topic is intriguing as it will give you the right technique that is required to write a travel blog, and also you will be accustomed yourself to the do's and don'ts that one should consider while drafting a travel blog. So, pack your bags, and let's get started. First of all, while writing a travel blog, you have to make this thing crystal clear in your mind that a travel blog is not the itinerary that you followed. Travel blogging is sharing your whole travel experience, be it your journey, your mode of transport, your stay in a hotel and the culture you experienced and the cuisine you had there, and a lot more, written on a microblogging website. While writing a travel blog, make sure that it makes your audience travel, entertained, and made them laugh. So, without wasting much of the time, let's get straight to the business. 1. Develop your style. The number one rule in travel blogging is that you have to be yourself. Never imitate anyone. Often we get hooked by our favorite travel blogger and we try to use the range of words that he used in his blog. We further wanted to create that ripple effect that he has induced in his travel blog. It is something natural and you can't resist it. But never fall into the trap of becoming someone else. Seeking motivation and following that similar pattern are two different things. You have to mind the difference between the two of them. 2. Develop your niche. This may sound similar to the first point that we discussed. But let's go ahead further, that explains it well in an all-around form. Every travel blogger has certainly carved a niche for them. For instance, one such travel blogger is Dylan Lowe. Dylan blogs have a distinctive style of using sesquipedalian phrases that is polysyllabic long words. Let's take another example of famous travel blogger Brenna Holman. She mainly discusses her experience on the road. So, you can see every travel writer has his strength and has an inclination towards the things that he likes the most. Always stick to our strengths, that is the major intake of the discussion. 3. Write in the first person. As a travel writer of the blog, it is your moral responsibility to create a similar effect with your audience as you have or had experienced. Avoid expressions like I felt, I was. I had. Instead make it a real feeling and use I feel, I am, I have. Make sure that nobody wants to read your boring story, as nobody actually cares. Secondly, most of the travel bloggers applies a technique that they record their live experience through their phones and voice recorder so that they can catch the exact dialogues of the locales. So, writing exact dialogues of the local people can be one of the strategy to write your blog in first person. 4. Make your headline an attractive one. Headlines are the hooks, so if the hook is loose, you won't retain your audience for long. Consider these headlines, "The Deadliest Trip to Mount Everest." So you can see with the headline like this, certainly make everyone eyes rolling. This headline certainly arises a lot of questions in the mind of the audience. 1. Why the trip was so deadliest? 2. What had happened with this blogger on his trip? 3. Was there some accident on the trip? The list of the questions is endless. And certainly, it has all the ingredients that a hook normally has with it. Other eye-catchy headlines can be, 5 reasons to visit New York in spring season, and 5 things I wish I knew before visiting Dubai, and many more headlines like that. 5. Avoid generic writing. A lot of amateur writers fall into the trap of generic writing. It means taking a blog of any travel writer as 10 reasons to visit Honolulu. You may replace Honolulu with Miami, as both Honolulu and Miami have warm weather. Though both the destinations have good food, have several beaches. But what made Honolulu different from visiting Miami? You have not told in your blog. Such a form of writing is a generic form of writing. If you have covered. 1. How long is the beach? 2. Was the beach crowded? 3. What do the beach vendors sell? These types of questions well answered in your blog will take it to a different level. 6. Travel blog is not journaling of the events. This is a valid point of discussion here. Though a travel blogger loves to write all the happenings on that particular day, but the way it has to be presented has to be different. Nobody gives a damn about anybody's event. This a bitter tablet, you must swallow it. Make sure that the events that you are mentioning in your blog need not be in chronological order. The best advice you can get on this is, stitch a story around your destination. People can relate to stories. 7. Take the opposite route. Now what the hell that means? Normally amateur travel writers start their blog with boarding the flight, landing the plane, clearing the customs, retrieval of the bags, and so on. This type of travel blog looks stale. Instead, take the opposite route. Talk about black water rafting in a cave while writing about the trip to New Zealand. Make your travel blog adventurous and don't follow the old rule of starting from the beginning. 8. Cut short your meaningless list. What does that mean? Let us come straight to the point. While having a trip to London, you may say London has a lot of art museums. But is this serving any purpose? What if the description goes like that? London has some well-known art museums, namely the British Museum and the National Art Gallery. But my favorite is the National Art Gallery, as it is located Trafalgar Square in the city of Westminster, in central London. Founded in 1824, it houses a collection of over 2,300 paintings dating from the mid-13th century to 1900. Can you see the difference? So don't beat around the bush. Be specific in your approach. So, this is for this week. We hope you have learned about the various specs of a travel blog. Catch you next week, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the bell icon for all the latest notifications. Bye for now and have a great weekend.